Hey, good morning and welcome to Living Hope. Thank you for joining us. Here's some information that we want you to know.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison door. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory.
Hey, good morning and welcome to Living Hope. Thank you for joining us. Here's some information that we want you to know. Hey, good morning and welcome to Living Hope. Thank you for joining us. Here's some information that we want you to know.
We won't be quiet.
Good morning, everyone. Let's stand together. Let's lift up our voices to the Lord.
Oh,
Hallelujah.
Good morning. I feel like, you guys, I feel like the old, my pastors in the past, and from way back, you guys ever remember saying this? It just kind of dropped in my spirit. Well, glory. You guys remember that? That's good stuff. Well, glory. It is good. Well, glory. Amen. Well, glory. I tell you, there's no better place to be than to worship, be worshiping His holy name. Amen. No better place on earth to be than just to be worshiping the Lord. And that's our intent today. We come here just to give Him thanks and to praise Him and to worship the Lord. It is good to see you. We're welcome everybody who's watching online as well. We just want to take a few minutes and worship the Lord in song some more. And just be free while you're worshiping. You know, if you need to come up here and worship, you're more than welcome to. If you need to sit down, you're more than welcome to do that. But I just exhort you to keep your eyes focused on the Lord and give Him the thanks and the praise that He is due. And let's just worship Him for a while in song. Amen.
Dark tried to hide you and steal you away. Death tried to keep you inside of the grave. The enemy fought you, he tried but he lost. You cannot be stopped. When we cried for freedom, you tore down the walls. The weight of our burdens, you carried them all. Our fears and our failures hang dead on the cross. Oh, you cannot be stopped. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus has triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Stand on your victory, and we shout out your praise. Miracle maker, you're mighty to save. You're awesome in power, relentless in love. Oh, you cannot be stopped. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against. against our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God.
We believe it.
There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing.
No.
Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God.
Let's go back into that bridge again. There's nothing.
There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing.
Oh, there's nothing.
There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. Oh, mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus is triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won. Nothing can stand against our God.
still make mistakes, but you have new mercies for me every day. Your love never fails. No, it doesn't. It never fails. It never fails. You stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes in. I know that you love me. Your love never fails. Your love never fails. The wind is strong and the waters deep. I'm not alone. Your love never fails. The chasm is far too wide. I never thought I'd reach the other side. Your love never fails. You stay the same.
He who began a good work in you is faithful to complete it. He makes all things work for good. And not all things are good. It's hard to see how difficult times, things that catch us off guard, can be worked together for our good and His glory. You know, but a drug addiction, that's not a good thing at all. But how many times have we seen and heard testimonies from people who were set free, and then God uses them to set 10 more people free? You know? And it's all things work together. There are people who have had difficulty in their marriage, and the Lord asks them to help others. And not only is their marriage restored, but God uses them to restore other marriages too.
You make all things work together for my good. And you make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my good.
Let's just keep singing that.
You make all things work together for my good. And you make all things work together for my good. And you make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my
So what's coming to me this morning is, are you ready to do the work? You know, all things do work together for our good, and sometimes these times of things working together for our good are painful, and they're hard. And I just think of a bodybuilder. You know, he starts with a little bit of weights, and he continues to lift more and more, and then he's sweating, having to come a little more often to strengthen himself. And it's just coming to me. It's like, are you ready to do that work? Yes, all things work together for our good. But I think it's like we need to keep moving towards Him. We've got to believe Him that these things that we're going through do work for our good. We don't understand them sometimes, and they are hard. But all things work together for our good, and the word is, are you ready to do the work?
Darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus.
darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, you silence fear. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, your name is a light that the shadows can't deny. Your name cannot be overcome. Your name is alive, forever lifted high. Your name cannot be overcome. Your name, your name is alive that the shadows can't deny. Your name cannot be overcome.
really is Jesus who's the difference maker. It's really Him. Love to say it's me or this church or any other church in Owensboro, but it's Jesus. It's Jesus. You know, one time there was a lady who had had a problem with bleeding for 12 years. She spent all she had at the doctors, and they couldn't figure out what was wrong. Couldn't get the problem fixed. And Jesus was just walking through on His way to do something else. And this lady knew that Jesus made the darkness tremble. And that Jesus was the difference maker. And she just reached out, knowing that if I just can touch Him, I'll be okay. I just feel like today, if you're here today and you need a touch from Jesus, let's just reach out and touch the hem of His garment right now. It's Jesus that's the difference maker. What do you need today? What do you need? Do you need? That's so funny. I ask my grandkids that, especially my youngest. What do you need? What do you need? When she's whimpering some. Today, God asks you, what do you need? You need deliverance from sin? Do you need a healing in your body? Do you need your family put back together? Do you need your marital relationship to be working like it's supposed to? What do you need today? I'm just asking you right now, just reach up and let's touch the hem of His garment and say, God, please meet this need in my life. Lord, I need more of You. I need more spiritual strength. I need more righteousness, more holiness inside of me. Holy Spirit, I want more. I want more of You in me, God. What do You need? Touch, reach out and grab His hem of His garment. Lord, thank You for being the difference maker. Lord, thank You for all that You do. Lord, You're the name that's above every name. At Your name, everything created, every person being created will bow. That's who You are. And so today, God, I just pray that You would minister to Your people. Lord, whatever need they may have, Lord Jesus, as the lady who touched Your garment was healed, Lord, bring healing to Your people. Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank You, Jesus. Lord, we give You thanks. We give You thanks. Hallelujah. You know, we serve a living God. And the Bible says of Him that doesn't He who created the mouth, can He speak? And He who created the ear, can't He hear? And it says, my sheep know my voice. So we can learn to hear from God. Now, that's a goal in my life, to be transparent with you guys. I want to hear from God just so I can get things right here on earth. I want to hear His voice speaking to my heart, speaking to my head, my ears. And sometimes He says things, and I always check it out and make sure it wasn't just the donuts that I had earlier. I want to make sure it's God before I say anything. And sometimes I just say it by faith. But today I just felt like while we were worshiping the Lord just kind of laid in my heart, in my mind, that I don't know if you're watching by camera today, but he wants to deliver somebody from addiction to drugs today. And I don't know who you are. I'm just glad for you. And I'm telling you, it's only Jesus that can deliver. And then Colin said, right after I kind of had that thought and that word go through me, Colin said, it's like somebody who's been addicted to drugs and been delivered, and then you tell others how they can be delivered. Well, look, I don't know if I was addicted, but I did it about every day. And when Jesus came into my heart and into my life, he changed everything. Everything was gone. All those addictions were gone. They were gone. So I'm that person today to tell you that Jesus set me free. And he wants to set you free today. So if that is you, all I want you to do is to say, Jesus, set me free from this addiction. If that's you watching today, God wants to set you free. Let him do it. Let him do it. Hallelujah. Can we sing Jesus, Jesus one more time? And we'll be done. Hallelujah.
Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, you silence fear. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, you silence fear. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus.
We've been gone a week. We've stored up a lot.
It's like Jerry said, you know, you do, we pray to hear God's voice and, you know, to hear God's voice and everything. But I feel like the Lord might be saying to somebody that he's getting ready to humble you. And when I think of humble me, it's like, oh, no, you know, I'm going to be embarrassed. And it's like, no, this humble is going to be like the Lord's going to answer that prayer that you have prayed for so long. And you're going to be so humbled in the best of ways.
God. Hallelujah. Can we just thank the Lord for his presence and all he's done? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. You guys can be seated. Let's thank this worship team also for doing such a good job. And if we could have the ushers to come forward at this time. We'll take an offering so we can hire somebody to move this around. I'm just kidding. We wouldn't do that. The Lord knows I could use exercise. So as the ushers are coming, let's just take a minute and let's pray over this offering, if you would, with me. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Lord, we're thankful. Lord, we give you thanks for how you provide for us, how you take care of us, God. Lord, thank you for your provision, your providing hand. Lord, I pray for those in need today. Lord, meet their financial needs. Those who are here today that, Lord, need a miracle from you, I just pray that you would do that even now. And God, I pray that you take this offering and use it for your glory, Lord. Use it however you choose to use it. Lord, we just pray that you help others come to know you through it. In Jesus' name, amen. Jimmy, why are you training that girl? She's taking it out as it goes by. All right, I guess Ashley will have to do the announcements live today. Anyway, we just have a few announcements, and they're, so the video wasn't made this week. Number one is this Saturday. Okay, all righty. This Saturday is the clothes closet. From 9 to 11, we are going to hand out clothes to those in need of clothes, but we're also going to love on the neighbors and whoever shows up, and hopefully have an opportunity to share more than just clothes with them, but share the good news of the Lord Jesus. And so if you want to help do that, be here at 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock Sunday, yes, that's right. Not Sunday, Saturday. 8 o'clock Saturday. That's why we have videos, so we don't get the wrong day. But yeah, if you want to do that, it's a great time in the Lord. It's wonderful to get to help people and get to hang out with the folks in the neighborhood and others. This week too, I know it's a week early, and we're missing a lot of kids and teachers this week, and we will be next week as well, because next week the youth are going on a retreat, and they'll be gone next weekend. But if I can have the children come forward, and instead of going out the door right off the bat, I just want you to line up down here. And Miss Destiny, if you could come forward with what you have, and all the kids, hey, all the teenagers too, Elijah, all the youth, come forward as well. As you guys know, we're getting ready to go back to school, and I guess anybody's going back to school who would like to be prayed for, we're going to do that for the students, and these girls can come too if they want. But we're going to take a minute and pray. I'm going to ask Miss Bridget, would you mind to come and pray over the kids for this school year? And we also have a neat little tag we're going to give every child. And if you're not here today and you want one, we'll get you one. We'll get one that they can put on their backpack. Can I see one? Thank you so much. And this little tag says, "This bag has been blessed by a congregation that loves and supports this student, Living Hope." And then on this side it says, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." So,
Father, we thank you for these children. We thank you for each and every one of them. God, I just pray as I stretch my hand out towards them and the whole congregation, Lord, we just join together believing that you have ordained each and every life that stands here as individuals. Lord, and I know that you watch over them and protect them, God. I remember the years when mine were little. That was one of my greatest concerns, is that they were protected. Lord, we pray that you protect them from illnesses. Lord, as we still seem to be walking under the shadow of the COVID situation, Lord, we ask divine protection and health over each and every one of them, that you protect them from any kind of illness, but especially this pandemic. We ask that you protect them, Lord, from those who may not be in their right minds, and I know that the parents are often worried about that. We've often heard of many things throughout the countryside where people have come in and caused damage and heartbreak to schools and loss of life, and this will not happen to our children. We decree and declare, Lord, that these children are not just, they don't belong just to their own parents, Lord, but that as parts of the body of Christ, that we all walk honorably towards you with love towards them, Lord, and we will pray over them daily, and we will commit ourselves, Lord, to pray and to be consistent and to speak words of hope and encouragement into them. And Lord, if any of them are here, I remember as a little one being shy, if they're shy and they're scared to go and they're scared of new places and new people, Lord, we just pray that they feel your warmth wrapped around them. Lord, we pray that they just feel joy. Lord, that you give them good friends and good people. And Lord, more than anything, Lord, I just keep thinking about that little song, "This Little Light of Mine, I'm Going to Let It Shine." And I just pray that each one of them understand that a light is in them and that they would shine for you, Lord, in all that they say and all that they do, in every influence that comes, Lord, to them, that they would resist anything negative, and, Lord, that they would be the leaders. God, I pray for leaders amongst this group here, that they all be leaders. Lord, we pray for good teachers. Teachers, Lord, we know that it's a hard job for them, and sometimes it's difficult, and they bring in things from their own home life, Lord, that may influence the way that they behave in class. And it's hard for us to separate those things. But we pray that each child be treated kindly and fairly. Lord, that they be treated according to their own need and that they grow and mature, not only in education and in friendship, Lord, and in culture, but that they grow and mature especially in you. Lord, I pray that their eyes be open, that their ears be open, that they would be able to be, even at this tender age, able to see the hand of God in their lives in everything and every way all day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And kids, before you leave, won't you go take your tag back to your parents real quick? Go take your tag to your parents, and then we'll let these guys go to children's church. And Destiny, you can stay right here. And I'm going to ask teachers and all staff, all school workers to come down and let us pray over you for just a second. All right. We are blessed with some wonderful teachers that come here to our church and staff, and we're blessed in our schools. Praise God. Would you pray with me again? Thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for these wonderful, godly teachers, Lord, that you've raised up, Lord. And we pray for them and for this school year, Lord. Lord, I just pray that let grace abound in every situation they face this year. Lord, give them just unique and wisdom and just amazing ways to teach. Lord God, I pray, Lord, that you give them peace at all times, Lord, in dealing with their classroom and dealing with children. Lord, I just pray that you be with these teachers and these staff members at school, Lord God. Lord, we just pray for your blessing upon them. And Lord, I pray that they also have opportunity to share your love with their students as they come through that door. Lord, I understand that they will be living that. That's what lives in them. But Lord, even for them to be able to speak it forth, Lord, to speak your name in public schools, Lord, we pray for that. Lord, just make just the right opportunities for them to lift up these children. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, teachers. We don't have anything. I guess you guys could have a tag, too. Thank God, we are in a battle, a spiritual battle, and it's nothing new. It's been going on since the beginning of time, and, but I thank God for our schools in Davis County and Owensboro. I know the superintendent of Davis County Schools. I know he loves the Lord. He's a good man, and I don't really know him, but I know there's wonderful, godly people throughout the school system, and I thank God for that. The problem tends to be that, they get issued and you get funding by a curriculum that you're supposed to use, and some of that can cause issues and problems, and some of that can water down truth. We're going to talk a little bit about that here in just a minute. But first of all, we just pray for Les today. Y'all scared him so bad last week, he's not coming back. No, I'm just teasing. He's not. He's feeling bad day. His eyes watering, Matthew, and he's just not feeling good. But I thank God for Les and a wonderful person. And Les, I'm going to affectionately tell you what everybody tells me whenever we have a Sunday morning where we just do music and worship the Lord, and I don't necessarily get to preach a sermon. I affectionately have people that tell me that was the best sermon you ever preached. So that was the best sermon you ever preached. But I know last week was different, but listen, I know many people got ministered to last week, and it was just a blessing. And it's odd for some haven't been around something like that, but God is good. And the best thing, yeah, I'll tell you this too, that sometimes it's not easy to stand right here. Because I think, do you guys see a target? Sometimes I think there's a target right here. And the enemy will fire his fiery darts. Pew, pew. And, you know, even Billy Graham, after he would get through speaking the most wonderful message and thousands of people would respond, they said he would often get in his car to go home and say, I did a terrible job. I wish I'd have done better. I wish I would have said this. I shouldn't have said that. And you know what? But I like that because it's a man who says, God, I want to do better. It's not a man that says, God, I got this all together. It's not if you can mend yourself that you're commended, but it's who the Lord commends that's commended. And so Les goes home and does that sometimes. And I go home and do that often. God, I wish I would have done better. I wish I'd have, you know, I just want, maybe one day, maybe for my birthday next year, whenever I start to speak, everybody would just fall on their knees and scream, I repent, just to make me feel good. Just to make me feel good. You know, when I speak, I want everybody, and I know you guys know Jesus, but I want everybody to know him and give their life to him. That's why we do what we do. And, but I want to tell you, I want to boast. This doesn't usually happen. Usually preachers get up and just tell you what you're doing wrong. But can I boast on Les for a minute? And I want to boast about you guys for just a minute. Because as I was thinking about last week, I was reading through the Bible on my own time. And I came across this scripture. You know, the best thing about most of you guys in here is where the position of your heart. Is that you love God and you just want him to have his way and you just want to do what pleases him. And when your heart is in that position, your life's going to be blessed. Your life's going to be blessed. So, and I know that's about Les. That's the first thing I told him because the enemy had beat him up. So I called him, I texted him earlier. No, I called him early Sunday after the service. And I called him, just left a message. He called me back. He went and took a nap. He was wiped out. Took a nap and said something like, I don't think I'm ever going to preach again. I said, oh, yes, you are. And then but the thing about Les is, here's the thing. His heart is right with God. He just wants God to bless you guys. And that's the same way that a lot of y'all's hearts is. Your heart's just right. You just want God's best for each other. And then I read this scripture, and it is a description of you guys and Les. And is Home Interior still in business? From young people have no idea. But the old people know they had that, used to have the, as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord plaque. And a lot of people still have it hanging in their house. But they need to put this scripture down and put it, hang it in your house. Because this is what matters. It's 1 Peter 3:8. 1 Peter 3:8. And it says this. Finally, all of you have unity of mind, sympathy, brotherly love, a tender heart, and a humble mind. There you go. There you go. Write that down and put it on your front door. Because if we can fulfill that, and God can make that, he can work that in you. And when he does, Look, you're on the road to many blessings in God. A tender heart and a humble mind. That's a great combination right there. And to be sympathetic and to have brotherly love and to have unity. That's what the garment we all need to put on right there. Amen. So bless you guys. Thank you. Patty and I got away last week. And I'm so thankful the Lord ministered to so many people here last week. And it was just such a blessing. So anyway, let's talk about going back to school a little bit. And I've often said, and I'm going to try not to preach the same sermon, but, you know, it was in my younger years that I kind of measure things that happened to me in my life, okay? My middle school years is when I started rebelling against God. Anybody else say amen to that? Middle school years, I started rebelling against God. Before then, I was pretty much on God's team, you know. I didn't know much. I was under God's grace, but I wasn't rebelling like I started to rebel. And I lived a few years there that were really rough, and just the consequences of living a rebellious life. And then my senior year in high school, though, I surrendered my heart and life to Jesus Christ halfway through my senior year in high school. I think that deserves a round of applause. And I'm telling you, we've never been the same since. It's been wonderful. I've never had a problem. Everything's been great. But what a difference Jesus made. He is a difference maker. So I go back and talk about the school time, and I love to talk about those things and talk to kids. It was really in the school system where I began to speak outside of my local church, because they had invited me to come speak at FCA events and different things. But I want to read this, and actually today's sermon, you guys have lunch plans? Actually, we're going to make it into a couple weeks, hopefully. But I just want to say this, that I'm thankful, and what I'm about to read, just bear with me and give me some grace for a minute. You know, our school systems in America, they were started with great intentions. Let me read you this. You guys ever heard of the Old Deluder Satan Act? It just happened the other day in 1647. You guys don't remember that? It was when the legislation in Massachusetts passed that bill, let me read it. It being one of the chief projects of the Old Deluders, what the guy said, Satan, to keep men from knowledge of the scriptures. So schools should be set up in the colony to teach children to read the scriptures. Every town that has 50 families was supposed to hire a teacher to teach children to read the Bible so they could avoid the problems that the Old Deluder would bring with an ignorance of God's revelation. So the schools in Massachusetts were set up in part to have kids learn how to read so they could read the scripture and not be deceived by the deceiver, the deluder of all time. And you know, and then when we get to higher education, I didn't take a lot down note-wise right here. I just took a few things. You know, Harvard was established Harvard, Yale, and Princeton, which you guys are probably all familiar with those higher learning education places, were all set up to train ministers. That was how they were initially set up. Harvard's motto was for Christ and the church and for the glory of Christ. And Yale admonished its students, above all, have an eye to the great end and all your studies, which is to obtain the clearest conceptions of divine things and to lead you to a saving knowledge of God in His Son, Jesus Christ. So we have drifted from our beginning. And now, I know. I'm not saying that these people were perfect. Sometimes we get that image in our mind. Whenever we read about in the Bible, like we're going to read about Daniel, it's like they're Teflon, like they're perfect, you know. And even people who set up schools with these purposes, like they're perfect. But no one on earth is perfect other than Patty. No one I know is perfect, okay? So, but I just want to say that I'm thankful. I'm thankful for our Christian heritage, and I know that it can be controversial these days. But I have come to know that there is one God in three persons, the Father, His Son Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. And only through Him can we live life as it was meant to be lived. And only through Him can we get to heaven when we leave this earth. So it is of the most importance to lead people to Him in everything we do. If we truly love people, we will tell them about the one true God so they can truly live and have eternal life. And we'll do this. We will do this at home. We'll do this at work. We should do this at schools. We should do this in our government. We should do this in the marketplace. Wherever we are, and through whatever means we have, we should proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ to people. Because one thing I know, people, is that this life is temporary. This life is not eternal. Here on earth, you know, you speak of global warming. There will be a great global warming one day. This earth, the Bible tells us, is going to burn up. It's going to burn up. And we're going to be in one of two places, either heaven or in hell. That's why it's so important to share the gospel wherever we are. You know, the enemy of God, he's the old deluder. He really is. He's a trickster. The Bible calls him crafty. The Bible calls him crafty. And, you know, he's always firing things that have some truth in them to us, but then a lot of delusion in it as well, a lot of untruth in it as well. And one thing, you know, I know talking even about what I just talked about with the school starting and the colleges and all that can be controversial these days. It's controversial. And please forgive me. I'm getting ready to step into a hornet's nest. And that's no fun. I got stung by one this week, I think. For just a minute. But listen. You know, sometimes we get tired of Christians getting picked on. But the truth is, it's been going on since Jesus was here, or even before that. And it will get worse in the future. And look, Jesus told us in John 15:20, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will persecute you. But here's the good news. It doesn't matter. The Lord's with us. The Lord's with us no matter what we go through. So lately, one attack, and I get it to some degree, but here's the thing. The devil always tries to paint Christians with a broad brush. You're all the same. You know, when I read this about the schools, it reminded me of the latest phrase that wants to make Christians go hide again. And that's, people are calling us, or using the term, I should say, Christian nationalist. Now, I understand to their degree what some are saying. I get it, but I don't think that everybody even knows what they're saying. Because honestly, I looked up the definition for that word yesterday. Some of you may be familiar with that, some may not. But I looked up the definition of those two words yesterday, and there was every definition I looked at was different. So everybody had a different definition. I think what's trying to be said is that some people believe that some Christians think that America is all that matters. And maybe that's why they're called Christian nationalists. But again, it gets painted with a broad brush. And we all get hit. I've been hit with that comment. But, I believe in essence that it is an attempt to silence Christians by using this term. And if you begin to speak up, if you begin to say, like, I want godliness and holiness and righteousness in my government, they will... Some people will label you that way. They will label you that way. Listen, y'all, you're already labeled. You're labeled. Did you know that the Bible calls you a peculiar people? Some of y'all are just strange. You're peculiar. You're peculiar people. When Jesus Christ comes into your life, he changes you. And the world thinks you're different then. If you're walking from Jesus, you will be different than them. You're peculiar. You know, and I would add, it is a good peculiar. It's good. It's good. Peculiar because you're full of love. That's weird. Because you love God and you love others. That's peculiar. To the world, that's peculiar. Peculiar because you treat others the way that you want to be treated, not necessarily the way they're treating you. That's peculiar. That's weird. That's odd. Peculiar because you look after those in need. Peculiar because you look after orphans and widows, your foster parents, and you look after those who are in need. That's peculiar. That's peculiar. Peculiar because you don't cheat on your spouse. What's wrong with y'all? You're weird. You are peculiar people. But you will be. The world will label you that. Don't let it make you go into hiding. Peculiar because trash is not coming out of your mouth constantly. You're peculiar. You're different. You're different. Peculiar because you're talking good about others and to others, building them up and not running them down. Peculiar because you're putting others before yourself, and peculiar because you're treating others with respect. That's what God's people should look like. That's the peculiar we should be. We are peculiar people. Peculiar because you bless those who curse you and pray for those who persecute you. Peculiar because you don't live in fear because you know God. God holds the future. You're peculiar people. You know, and the Bible says in 1 Peter 4:4, we can put that one up there. It even says this about the world and how they'll treat you. They are surprised that you do not join them in their recklessness, wild living, and they heap abuse on you. They're surprised that you don't join into their wild living. They don't join. But you know what? Anybody ever been in the wild living? It only brings up, it's not good endings, is it? No. It's never good endings. But you know what? It's surprise, but I can remember even going back to high school, Rebecca and Neil have left, but Neil's big brother was a Christian. And I wasn't surprised that he didn't join me in the reckless wild living. Actually, I kind of honored him. I'm thinking, that guy's got it together. And look at me. I don't have it together. But living in reckless wild living only brings you defeat and hurt and consequences to live with. So, but this is peculiar to the world. It's peculiar to the world that you don't live that way. So listen, don't worry about the labels. Don't worry about the labels. Just show them the fruit. Just show them the fruit. So let's talk about this for just a minute. Some of you may be familiar, some may not, but just to let me vent for a minute, if you will. You know, if you're asking me, am I a Christian nationalist? And if you're asking me, do I believe that America has taken Israel's place as God's chosen nation? No, I don't. I also believe that God loves the people in China and Russia and Australia and Peru and Honduras and everywhere else around this planet as much as he does us Americans. But I also believe with all my heart that the Bible is the Word of God. And that tells me in Proverbs 14:34 that righteousness exalts a nation. Righteousness exalts a nation. That means doing the right thing exalts a nation. And you find out what the right thing is from God. You can find that out by reading the Bible. The right thing comes from Him. And to exalt means to raise up, to elevate, to build up. Webster Dictionary says to raise in rank, power, wealth, or character. So if you ask me, do I want men and women in my country, in my state, in my town, in political office that serve God and follow His ways to live righteously and to promote righteousness, then absolutely I do. Absolutely. Because it's best for everyone. Righteousness is best for everyone. It's a no-brainer. The rest of that Bible verse we read said, sin is a reproach to any people. Just the opposite of being exalted. It brings you down. It's a disgrace. So I want the best. But you know what? I am pulling for this nation. And I want Christians in every area. I want everybody in America to love the Lord and know Jesus and be a Christian and go to heaven. Think of the changes that we would have in our society. No more child pornography. No more child trafficking. No more meth addicts. I know you're saying, Jerry, come on now. You're wanting heaven on earth. Yes, I do. I'm guilty. I do. I really do. And Jesus even said that in his prayer. Pray, my kingdom come, my will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So yes, I'm gonna fight for that till there's no breath left in this body. I want everybody to come to know the Lord so that they can live a life they're supposed to live and make it to heaven when they leave this earth. But you know what? You could probably call me a Christian worldist. Now, I know that's not a word. Worldist is not a word. But you know what? Because I not only want that for America, but I want that for the whole world, for everybody on this planet. I want them to know the Lord, come to Him. But you know what? I think I'm in good company in my wanting that, because anybody in here ever quoted John 3:16? What's it say? For God so loved who? The world. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So when the world says things, there's going to be people constantly attacking. Sometimes people say things because it's whispered in their ear by the old deluder. It really is. And they don't even know. There's a Bible verse that says people are taken captive to do the devil's will. That's in Timothy. We didn't write that one down. Actually, I'm just into my introduction. We're going to wrap this up, and we'll do the rest next week, talking about Daniel and his gang. But sometimes people are, the enemy is at work. Look, y'all, we really are in a battle for the soul of this nation. And I know that's some fancy words, but let me tell you what that means. That means there's a lot of people around us in this nation who are struggling, and they need Jesus. And I'm telling you, we sang it earlier, Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. He still does. He's the answer. And I want to get that answer out there, whether it falls on deaf ears or not. I'm going to proclaim it. And I'm not going to let anybody else say, oh, if you talk this way, you're a certain kind of person. I'm not. I just love people. And I only love people because God loves me. And his love is inside of me now, and it causes me to love people. I can't help it. I can't help it. If you truly love God, if you truly love God, you're going to be in trouble. If you truly accepted Jesus into your heart, you're going to find yourself liking and loving people that are hard to like and love. It's just going to happen to you. And if you don't like and love people, get back on your knees and say, God, I need some changes in me. Because the Bible says they'll know you're a Christian by your love. By your love. And for me, I loved 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. We read it at weddings. But I love the love chapter, pun intended. I loved it because I was from the school of boy. I didn't know what love was. Patty used to write me those notes. Do you love me? Check yes or no. She still does. But I didn't know that until I read chapter 13 of 1 Corinthians what it's supposed to look like. But when you love God, I'll tell you this, when you love God, it will change how you feel about everybody else in the world. Because you will have the same love that God has for them. You will want to help them. You will want to build them up. You will want to say the right things to them. Now, we're not perfect. We'll mess up and say wrong things. Don't get me wrong. We'll mess up because we still live in this human fleshly body. But our main purpose will be to love other people into the kingdom of God. So don't let the old deluder, he always wants to push you back into the closet. Don't go in there. Unless it's the prayer closet, then you can go in there. But if it's the closet where you can't lift your voice in the marketplace, that's the main reason why. That's the main reason why we hear stuff like Christian nationalists and those kind of things. Now I know there's a group of people who believe that. There's a group of people who believe there's no hell. There's a group of people that believe that aliens are coming to get us. There's all kinds of groups of people, but you cannot brush the broad brush across all Christians and say if you say anything positive toward our nation, you're a Christian nationalist and your voice don't even count. It's not true. It's not true. And listen, I'm not trying to get you to be like me anyway. I'm trying to get you to be like Jesus. You need him in your life. So don't let anybody quiet your voice. Speak up. That is the intent of that, is to silence the Christians in the mainstream. We don't belong there. Hey, we belong everywhere. Jesus belongs everywhere. Everywhere. Okay, that's my introduction. I gave Kaylin scriptures. She sent back, wow, or something like that. Because there was about 20 or so on there, 15, 10, I don't know. But she's like, and I had to call her and explain what was going on. I was like, I'm probably not going to get through all these today, but we'll head that way and we'll get finished next week with them. But I just encourage you to love God and to love people. And if you're struggling with that, there's a great remedy. It's just asking God to help you, to change you. And you know, one of the best things about God, the Holy Spirit lets us know where we're at with him. We know in our hearts. We know. We know if we need to get closer. We know if we're just being standoffish. We know if we've turned our back and are being rebellious against Him. Wherever you are, if you're in a bad spot especially, go to the Lord and ask Him for His help to change you. And He will. Would you stand with me, please? Would the band come forward? I think the theme running today has been Jesus, Jesus. He makes the darkness tremble. He's a difference maker. And so if your life, if you're struggling, if you know you just don't have the Lord where He belongs in your life, if maybe you're here and you've never said, Lord, I want to serve You. You've never asked Him into your heart and into your life. I just want to give anybody and everybody an opportunity today. As the band plays this next song, I'm just going to be up here. And if you want prayer for anything, but especially if you want prayer today to ask Jesus Christ into your heart and life, don't put it off. Don't walk out of here without doing that. You want to get that right before you leave. You don't want to leave here with that not right. And even now, as I say those kind of things, I know the Holy Spirit goes to work. I don't know, some people's heart starts acting a little funny at times. And I've had people tell me that after they leave, they say, gosh, you know, after I should have, my heart was pounding, I should have come up there, but I didn't, you know. But I want to tell you today, don't let that be you. If your heart's moving on you, if that's the Holy Spirit, just come on down. We're going to pray, and you'll be glad, and so will everybody else here be. And as we sing this final song.
Going back, how amazing to know. pressing on. I'll keep going strong. I'll keep singing the same song. We've only just begun. We've only just begun. I'm not going back, never going back. How amazing to know that we've only just begun. Yes, we've only just begun. I'll keep pressing.
Guys, for being here today. Carl, would you mind to close us in prayer, please?
Thanks for being a part of the service this morning. We hope you have a great week. If you would like to rewatch Pastor's message from this morning or a previous message, check out our YouTube at Living Hope Owensboro. And if you would like to know more about what's going on here at Living Hope, find us right here on Facebook and Instagram.
We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore.